Welcome students in this channel of Physics New Era. Today we are going to know about the surface energy and surface tension. But initially we are going to know about the surface energy. This concept is very very simple. Initially in the last subtopic we saw already that when the molecules at different position they are situated inside the liquid at the surface or touching the surface and on the surface of the liquid. Exactly when molecule is inside the liquid, it is surrounded by a similar kind of molecules, and that's why there is a cohesive force which is acting on that particular molecule which is inside the liquid. Seems to be the molecule A. The molecule A is pulled from the upward, downward, front side, back side, left, right, in all possible direction. Hence, resultant cohesive force is nullified. It is zero. And we need to consider now the molecule at the surface. Now other molecules which are at the surface, they are holding together just like the diagram it is shown there. The molecule inside the liquid which is shown there with a different color, that is red color, it is attracted by all the molecules which are beside it, and hence resultant cohesive force is zero. But as we go toward the surface, see the molecule at the surface which is present, it is holding by the all other molecules on the surface, and hence we say that all these molecules holding them, that is they give the support, but our cohesive force is more as compared to the adhesive force. Adhesive force is a force which is in between the liquid molecule and air molecule, which is very less, it is negligible. So only cohesive force which is pulling the molecule inward. As we draw the conclusion that as we go towards the surface, the cohesive force increases, and hence surface molecule is pulled inside, and below that one number of molecules they exist, they will take its position. But while taking the position of that molecule from lower side to the surface, it will have to do some sort of work against the cohesive force. So that is stored in the form of potential energy. That work is stored in the form of potential energy, and that is known as a surface energy. Okay, surface energy. So see the diagram. See, it will go outside. Here it is, and the molecule take its new position. Hence surface energy, surface energy, we are going to write the formula. Surface energy is nothing but work done by that molecule, work done by the molecule which is inside the liquid to take the position at the surface per unit area. This is your formula regarding the surface energy. Now what about the unit? The unit of that one is very simple. Work is having the unit joule, and area, that is meter square. Joule per meter square. This is the unit for the surface energy. And dimension of the surface energy which is given by m raised to power 1, L raised to power 2, T raised to power minus 2. Now we are going to know about surface tension. In this surface tension, it is nothing but, surface tension is nothing but, it is denoted by the symbol T. So force per unit length acting right angle to the line which is drawn on the surface of the liquid is known as surface tension. How? That we are going to draw now. Let us consider this is the surface. Okay, this one is the surface, and this is the line which is drawn here. Now the perpendicular force per unit length, this is the unit length seems to be considered. So force acting per unit length on an imaginary line which is drawn on the surface. Perpendicular to that line, we say that it is nothing but a surface tension. What about the unit? Unit is, we know the force is having the unit Newton and a length is having the unit meter. So what about the dimension? So dimension, which is given by, okay, here I'm going to write the dimension. The dimension, it is given by m raised to power 1, l raised to power 0 and t raised to power minus 2. This is the dimension regarding the surface tension. Now we have the applications of surface tension. Here we know that when we are going to use a brushing teeth, we are going to utilize a toothpaste. This toothpaste plays a vital role to spread that while washing the teeth, it is easily get spread in our mouth and it reduces the surface tension in between brush and teeth. And hence, we are going to remove the all tar which is present on the teeth and teeth becomes clean. Similarly, number two, while washing the clothes, when we are going to add a detergent, it reduces the surface tension and it will spread overall on the clothes and remove the stains on the clothes. This is your second application of your surface tension. Thank you.